There's a news outlet called Complex. I'm not very familiar with them. Maybe you guys are. But apparently they did a top 10 pound-for-pound boxing list that is way, way, way off. And it's so bad, I just have to share it with you guys. Obviously, Gervonta Davis, one of the best pound-for-pound fighters on the planet, a current champion at 135 and 130, 24-0, 23 knockouts, just knocked out Leo Santa Cruz, is not on their list. The Charlos are not on their list. David Benavidez, not on their list. Manny Pacquiao, a champion at 147, one of the greatest fighters ever. Ever, not on their list. And it's just funny to me. Anybody can write about boxing and make a post and yet miss it so bad. So who do they have on their list? Let me share it with you. Check it out. It's funny because Mikey Garcia, when he won his fourth division champ, he was a fourth division champion. Almost no one put him on the pound for pound list. Leo Santa Cruz, fourth division champ. No one put him on the pound for pound list. Abner Morris, four division champ. No one put him on. So there's certain fighters that just get hated on more than other fighters. And certain fighters, I guess people who cover boxing are not familiar with them unless they watch one specific network. So here's the top 10 pound-for-pound list from Complex. And let me know what you guys think about this list. Like I said, for me, it's missing Tank. It's missing the Charlos. It's missing Pacquiao. It's missing Benavidez. Just to start with a few. So they have number 10, Juan Francisco Estrada. Number 9, Oscar Valdez. Number 8, Vasyl Lomachenko. Number 7, Usyk. Number 6, Teofimo. Number 5, Fury. Number 4, Spence. Number 3, Inoue. Number 2, Crawford. And number 1, Canelo. The only thing I agree about their list is that Canelo is number 1. And that's it. I don't agree with anything else on the list, because even when they do put Errol Spence in there, and Errol Spence is a legendary fighter, a great fighter. Errol Spence is the number 1 147 fighter on the planet, fought the toughest people, and for me, he's number 2 after Canelo. You can't put Inoue in front of him, like I said. Why is Inoue in there and you don't put Tank in there? Why is Inoue in there and not Charlos? Charlos a unified champ. Why is Inoue in there and not David Benavidez? Pound for pound, David Benavidez is one of the baddest people on the planet. Whether you're a fan of his or not, skills pay the bills. And that's just to give you an example. So that was their pound for pound. What do you guys think? Who's your pound for pound list? And do you agree with their list or not? Manny Pacquiao, one of the best fighters ever. And he's a champion. He's the highest level. Your pound for pound list is trash if Manny Pacquiao is not on your top 10. I'm sorry. I don't care who it is. I don't care who listens to this and takes offense to it. Your pound-for-pound list is trash if a legend like Pacquiao is not in your top 10. End the story. No excuses, nothing. Manny Pacquiao, over 70 fights, 62 wins, 39 by knockout, and the only 8th division champion in boxing. So I guess Tank doesn't have to feel too bad because Tank is not on the list, and Manny's not on the list. The Charlos should be on the list. Jermell and Jermall Charlo, they are among the best fighters on the planet, and they're not on the list. And David Benavidez. And those are just 5 fighters that I'm mentioning off the top of my head that come to mind. Why someone who doesn't know about boxing or doesn't know much about boxing and just writes for an outlet, who does he think are his top 10 pound-for-pound champions? So there you have it. Stay tuned. FayezNewsReport.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. You can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback. And you can follow Gervonta at Gervonta with 2 A's. You can follow Charlo at Future of Boxing or Twin Charlo. And you can follow Manny Pacquiao at Manny Pacquiao. And you can follow David Benavidez at Benavidez 300.